We are from 70. Let us read Bodo language. Kulambar, hello. Natarni Mungama, what is your name? Atni Munga Chandrana. My name is Logeshwari. Natarni Majwari Dam. How are you? I'm Majwari Dam. I'm fine. Kulambar, hello. Natarni Mungama, what is your name? Atni Munga Chandrana.
When you compare our country in 1947 to 2018, you can see many dramatic changes took place in India. If you see our country in 1947, India was full of conservatism, classism, people were separated and suppressed in name of religion. We used to follow low caste, high caste privacy in our country. But a person who experienced all the bitter experiences in life, being a Dalit, he himself had an illusion that he will bring a legal framework for our country. He was another than Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, sir, who is also known as architect of the Constitution of India. That is illusion, is our today's reality. Now let's come to the topic. My topic is laws, rules and measures taken up by the Indian government for the upliftment of scheduled caste and scheduled tribe group. Let us break down into three equal halves, that is constitutional reforms, economic reforms and educational reforms. Constitutional reforms. Article 17 clearly states that to abolish untouchability in our country. Article 16 subsection 4, it says that whether it may be any education board in India must provide some minimum quotas for SKNS students to clear all kind of government examinations. Article 338 of Indian Constitution says that it orders the state government to provide nearly 1/4 of total India's land population for agriculture as well as for industrial purposes to SKNS people. If the land is used for agricultural purposes, to provide them cheaper credit facilities, provide them more financial facilities to empower them. So these are some constitutional reforms which have been taken up by the Indian government for the empowerment of SKNS people. Then the second one comes to educational reforms. Each and every state government in India takes up many reforms in the field of education for SKNS people. First one is providing them pre-matric and post-matric scholarship, free coaching for professional education like MBBS, Chartered Accountancy, etc. It also provides them first preference in all schools and colleges for admissions. Then last one comes financial reforms. Financial reforms, many new schemes and programs have been launched by the central government of India. For example, National Scheduled Caste Scheduled Tribe Financial Development Corporation, National SCNC Financial Development Corporation, National Supply Compensation Financial Development Corporation. So these are some of the legal frameworks which have been followed, some of the schemes which have been followed by the government. And at last, I just like to conclude my speech by stating that India is a country where great were born and great were buried. We must be united within ourselves because nothing is going to work unless you work. No mosque, no church, no temple, nothing is going to help you unless you help yourself. Thank you, Jai.
ஐயோ இப்படி ஆயிடுச்சு கவனமா உடற்பயிற்சி செய்யணும் சொல்லுங்க.
அடிபட்டு